In this video, we will talk about distributed load testing and show how to easily create and perform a distributed load test using SmartMeter. We will go through a complete test scenario, we'll set the test environment, run the test, and generate the test report. Let's start by opening SmartMeter welcome screen as we already have, and then open the editor. First of all, we have to set the environment. Now, this will slightly differ for each use case. Click File and open one of the prepared scripts. In this case, we'll use a script called SSH Multiple Generators, one per server. It means that the controller will run locally on your computer, and there will be also two load generators, each running on its own dedicated server. Thanks to this template, it'll be quite simple to do the rest of the settings. Okay, so let's take a look at what this script contains. In the tab User-Defined Variables, you can set variables specific to your test. We'll talk more about this later on in this video. When you look inside the script, you can see two prepared generators and the controller. So now let's take a look at the first generator. The preparation of the distributed test includes several steps. Firstly, the SSH connection needs to be established. And the first thing you want to set is the host name of your server, where the first generator is located. The generator is supposed to be already uploaded to this server. To do that, just upload a licensed copy of SmartMeter to the server. And we have already done that, so let's take a look. So I just connected to our Linux server containing the generator, and I can see it's uploaded to this folder, so everything's fine. Here is the path. It's important to know the path to the generator. Okay, but now let's get back to the settings. The first line contains the name of the test that will run here, and here you define on which hosts and ports the generators will run. Since we use SSH connection, it is localhost. Then this field contains the path to the generator on the server. And here you have to set your username for SSH session. Okay, and instead of passwords, we use SSH keys, so you have to set the path to your SSH key. And also the path to the file containing the SSH key password. And these fields need to be filled according to your test environment, of course. So after the SSH connection is created, different tunnels open. As you can see, there's no need to explain these in more detail at the moment. They are necessary to allow smooth communication between generators, controller, monitoring agent, and so on. And this command starts the generator itself. Okay, so this whole node contains everything required to start the first generator. And settings for the second generator are very similar. The only thing that you have to change is the host name. In this example, there is only a slight change in its name. It's generator number 2. And the rest of the fields is the same as in the first generator. Right, and the rest is exactly the same. The ports open and the generator starts. Okay, so generators are ready for the test, and now let's take a look at the controller. It contains commands to start an agent, to monitor the loads, and data server to handle the test data. And of course, also the test itself. And that's it. The distributed test is now ready to start. Just don't forget to save it, and then you can run the test. To run it, just click on the Run Test in Distributed Mode button, the red arrow located in the upper right corner, and the test starts. The first thing that opens is the monitor. It gets through the configuration script and it prepares the environment. As you can see, the connections open, as well as tunnels, and first and the second generator. And the test itself starts as well. Now this is the controller where you can watch the test progression. In the right upper corner you can see the growing number of users, and the runner tab contains live test results. They show you how the test is going so far in real time. If you want, you can also customize these graphs even during the test run. If you want to see another graph, just drag and drop it onto any graph in the window to switch them, and after a little while it'll start showing the data. There are no errors so far, as you can see. Okay, so let's put back hits per second graph. Here you can see the number of hits and responses. Right now we are testing simple static websites, so the responses are quick. And at the moment there is almost 1,000 users in the test. We are also generating about 500 hits per second. And the server seems okay so far. Responses are still quite quick. And the number of hits is still growing, as well as the number of transactions, while more users are being generated. Okay, so I guess we can stop the test now and take a look at generating a test report. To stop the test, just click this button in the left upper corner here. Now we have to wait a little while until all transactions end. Okay, so the report is created. It opens automatically in a browser window. It contains all the results of the test, and as you can see, there was no error during the test. At the top of the report there's a statistics summary. We have simulated over 2,000 users, and average throughput was about 5 megabytes per second, and about 136,000 of it was made. Okay, below there are all the graphs, such as hits per second, number of users, and so on. Okay, so that's it for this video, and thanks for watching.